tried to play in Ninkovic again, and Victory, having been under pressure, can now break forward, and that is some pass from Rojas for Fellaini! Melbourne Victory are in front in the big blue. Ben Fellaini with the clinical finish after a length of the field raid and a fantastic pass from Marco Rojas.
And it's a sublime finish. He only has that small corner to hit and he tucks it right inside the post.
Campsoba. Again, they're affording Elvis Campsoba space here, and we've seen this season that he can benefit from that as Buhaja's ball in. The chance for Ninkovic! And Miloš Ninkovic returns to the starting 11 and gets his first goal of the campaign. And we are back on level terms, and it's no less than Sydney deserve. Brillante. Nigro, great ball in. Fellaini, what a save! Well, he's been around the A-League for years and years as a number two, but Thomas Hewitt-Bell just pulled out a contender for save of the season. Fellaini, wonderfully done, elegantly done. Fellaini still, and there it is! Robbie Cruz! Celebrations on the bench. And celebrations in the stands. And just in front of them, Robbie Cruz, the former Socceroo, with his first of the season. He won't get an easier opportunity. Bring out all the artillery, and they are back on level terms. And it's Bobo, the experienced man, the Brazilian, who was the key to three consecutive victories last season, strikes again.
It's over, they have to concentrate. They've still got 10 minutes or so to get this game back in their favour.
And here comes Cruz, tries to curl one. And that wasn't far away either. With the little dink towards the back post where neither Economides, but it's back in again. And the header from Leighton Brooks getting up over Burgess.
Well, the action's coming so thick and fast, I can just sit back and admire it.
Was Archie Thompson alongside Michael Zappone because he was fighting hard for those chips.
That was pizza.
So hard for those chips, pizza. Archie. If you're hungry, a man's got to eat. Look, on a more serious note, Ray Marchand and that huge head clash with Jason Guerrier. Do you have an update on how Ray Marchand is? It looked horrible.
Yeah, the word from the Melbourne Victory bench was that it was really ugly, and we saw him, he was stretched off right in front of us. He had his hand on his head and blood everywhere. They were really concerned about his eye socket, Archie, just underneath the eye there. That looked like it was caved in, and he had another cut above his head. So he was straight to hospital, and let's just hope it's not a broken cheekbone or eye socket, because that's a long-term injury.
Yeah, he didn't look well, and obviously with a big head clash like that, but it was really not needed. Like, I mean, you could almost hear Jason Guerrier ask for that ball. Like, and then he was disappointed when he's looked down at Charan and he's obviously on the ground. But look, hopefully it's nothing too serious, because they need him, because he's so instrumental in the middle of the park. Breaks up a lot of play, starts a lot of play, so hopefully it's nothing too serious.
One of the things that you really understand when you're sitting here on the sideline, guys, is the energy that the players feed off it here at Amy Park. And Miloš Ninkovic made a really interesting point after the game in that interview. He pleaded with Sydney FC fans to get to the stadium, to get to Kogarah next week, because they need their support. He would have come here tonight and felt something different they haven't seen at Kogarah Oval this year.
Well, I think also too with the performances of Melbourne Victory, a large part of it is due to the squad and obviously what Popper's doing, but a big part of it too is the atmosphere and the supporters and what they bring. And I could probably echo the same as what Ninkovic is saying to his supporters, because they are sometimes the ones that get them out of situations and what they're in. But Sydney FC's performance tonight was fantastic. I mean, when you're looking at something to build confidence from, I look at all the obstacles they're up against. They're missing key players. They've lost Ryan Grant, Joel King,
Andrew Redmayne.
They've lost Lafondra, Costa Babarousis, Luke Bratton. I mean, this is a very skinny team, you could say, at the moment. But to come out here and put a performance on like they did was amazing. And look, too, I think with Melbourne Victory, they've had the issues with COVID. There's been a lot of talk about some players not being able to recover well from that. There was glimpses of it maybe tonight, and that's rustiness too. But I'm sure they'll be, have this performance under the belt. Look forward to Saturday because that's a big match. That's a big match against Wellington. They put them into a final situation where they can come back here, have the support of Melbourne Victory fans, and it's an opportunity to win trophies. But if you're a Sydney FC fan, a Sydney FC player, you'd be really proud of the boys tonight.
Yeah, plenty of upside, and Steve Corica had a big smile on his face at the end, Tara. Huge relief for him, and that hopefully that gives them some momentum for the rest of the season.
Yeah, hopefully so. See you guys back at Amy Park for the Socceroos on Thursday. Dinner is on Archie Thompson. Let's take a look at the Harvey Norman highlights right now. Four goals to get through. It was two goals apiece in this one between Melbourne Victory and Sydney FC. Ben Salami got us off and running on this slick counter-attack. It was just gorgeous, particularly this ball from Marco Rojas.
Yeah, absolutely fantastic vision and ball execution. It's not an easy pass to play on the run, and we spoke about how good that finish was. But interesting enough, and just moments before up the other end, I think it was Cam Sober has a wonderful chance to shoot, makes the wrong choice, and then within a matter of seconds they find the ball in their own net.
And it seemed like that was the sort of story of how things had gone up to that point. Sydney, with like they have in many games, had a great opportunity, didn't take it, and then the opposition go down and score a goal. But this one here was, again, just a lot of composure from three different players. Cam Sober, Bahaja, and then Ninko showing his class at the very end with players diving everywhere just to hold for that last second.
That one there, that's something that you can't teach players. That's something that you have to have as a footballer, isn't it? Just that instinct to take that little touch and to slot it away.
And pure intelligence as well. Again, you can't teach that. Ninko's got that in spades. And this one here, I mean, we don't know whether that was a shot or a cross, but Robbie Cruz there, ghosting in as a good sort of forward and striker and goal poacher does. He, he knew that if it was low and hard, he was going to have a chance. And Falami, what a great game he had. But like I said before, this goal so quick after Melbourne Victory took the lead, I felt with Victory's goal that they were just going to go on with it from there. And I think the longer the game had gone without that equaliser, it would have been all Victory. So a huge goal there from Bobo.
Big debate there as well on how teams mark, whether they man mark, whether they zone. And it looked there, the Victory very much zonal. Bobo so strong in the air, four players around him and basically unchallenged.
You can see the 3-2-1s, the Isuzu Ute man of the match. Ben Falami, Milos Ninkovic with two and Patrick Yazbek with the one. Ben Falami, the 22-year-old, absolutely outstanding. Let's hear from him now.
Oh, how good was this young man tonight, Tara? We're really enjoying him blossoming as a footballer, and he seems to grow every week. Well done, Ben Falami, Isuzu man of the match tonight. How do you describe that 90 minutes, 98 minutes? It was pulsating from the sideline.
Yeah, crazy 98 minutes of football. Look, on another day, we come away with 3 points. I'm disappointed to not take the big chance I had in the second half. But we'll have a chance to get him again. We go again next week and take it from there.
You've got to focus on the positives though, don't you? And you did two wonderful things that changed the course of the game tonight, scoring one and setting one up. Talk about that goal you scored, because the ball from Marco Rojas was 50 metres long, but to control it the way you did and to dummy and then finish, it wasn't an easy one to finish.
Yeah, it wasn't an easy one, but sometimes luck's on my side, so sometimes you just got to hit it. That's what I did. Luckily enough, I went across the keeper and into the bottom corner, so I'll take it.
Oh, there's more than luck involved. Good skill involved. And then the second one, the one you set up for Robbie Cruz. You just look like you've got a lot more confidence now running at players and getting in behind.
Yeah, I definitely feel more confident, whether I'm on the left or the right. I think sometimes there's situations in games where I think I've got to do something here to change it. So I thought that was one of those moments. And luckily enough, it worked out for me.
I think we've spoken about this before, but the difference between this year and last year, it's chalk and cheese. Talk to us about what Tony Popovic has done to help you lift your game to another level.
On a personal level, everything we do individually and as a team is detailed. His standards are very, very high all the time. You can never slack off. And these things all add up. So we know now, as players and as a team, we can never take our foot off the gas, you know. He always demands 100%. And this environment that we have now is what's changed from last season to this season, so it's really good.
Thanks for joining us. Well done tonight.
Cool, thank you. Appreciate it.
Yeah, what an absolutely outstanding performance from this young gun who's really gotten such a big opportunity with the side under Tony Popovich, and he's flourished, hasn't he, Millsy?
Yeah, he's been excellent, and we were just talking about him before, since he's come back to Australia. Obviously, tough year for all of Victory last year, but, you know, he's coming on in leaps and bounds at the moment. He's just so positive with the ball. He likes getting at players. He has a final pass, whether that last one to Cruzy was meant or not. Still, we're saying to go low and hard across the keeper. That's, you know, that's very hard to defend against. It either goes in, keeper makes a save, or you have someone like Cruzy following up. But he's just so positive, and he's a handful for whatever team they've played this season.
Yeah, you can see, obviously, that comes with confidence shown by the manager. With Tony Popovich, he's played him in every single game this year, started him in every game. And you look at that front line that they have with Rojas, Majota, Robbie Cruz, D'Agostino. Incredible lineup they have going forward. And the fact that he's playing every game, that must give him, as a young kid, so much confidence. And you can see it. Every time he got the ball, he looked confident. He was doing stepovers, but with purpose and with an outcome as well.
Yeah, and at times this season as well, he's been keeping big players out of this starting lineup, likes of Robbie Cruz. You know, Rojas hasn't started every game. Chrissy Economides, I know he's had his injury worries, but Flamie's been there, been strong, and he's done well to keep his spot.
And good to see him score then on top of that, you know, just to reward, I guess, all the good play that he's had this year.
Great to see the young players getting an opportunity and standing up when it counts. What a big blue it was, live from Amy Park. A 2-2 the spoil shared. In the end, Sydney FC, they bounce back, find a little bit of form, even though they have to settle with a point. Mark Millican, Alex Brosk, an absolute pleasure as per usual. You enjoyed some Portuguese tarts in the break.
I did. Can report back. Grab a few more on the way out.
We'll see. Maybe take some home. Thanks so much for your company at home. We'll see you all for more football action with the Socceroos on Thursday night. See you soon. Time, energy. Waiters, haters talking about it, kind of elderly. Throwing numbers on the board, no jeopardy. Started at the bottom, now they want a referee. Got a lot of shots, aiming for the centerpiece. Out of time, but all the drama is a heavy lead. Hey, yo, we can bring it fast and y'all move slow. When we get the pass, let's go, let's go. When we take the shots, you know, like, hey.